Would help if I open my camera. Okay, I'm going to show you what a finished flipbook looks like, and please put more information than less, okay? I will consider giving bonus points or extra points if you give me more information than I asked for. So the first thing you're going to do is get a sheet of paper and a cardstock works best. Full sheet, fold it this way. Okay, so that when you cut them, it opens up. Okay. I want you to, so you've chosen an animal by now. Okay, choose an animal that you want to do your flipbook on, and we're going to do the whole taxonomy rankings on it. So the first thing you do before you cut it is to put a picture down lightly, so it's kind of in the background. And I don't know if you can see this, but I did the Summit Academy bear. So you cannot choose the bear or the dog or the cat, okay? So whatever animal you do choose, do a light sketch in the background, color it in lightly so that when you write over the taxonomy levels, you can, that's really what you see the most, okay? So you will use, you need 8 flaps. The best way to do this is just over an inch, just barely, because it's 8.5 inches down this way. So if you do just over an inch for every line, okay, then that's the best way. Okay, picture first, draw the lines, cut it. And then for the inside, how I do it is I put one of these down and I do a line above it and below it. Then I skip one, hold this one down, do a line above it and below it. Same one, skip, do a line above it and below it. So that as you open this, the only thing you see is everything that goes with you, the domain, okay? Once that is done, you can go to the front and do the DKP, Deer, King, Philip came over for good food, right? But fill in the actual taxa levels. And then whatever your animal is, which everybody will be domain eukaryote, right? So you write eukaryote on the inside flap. And then on the right side, on the inside, you will write what a eukaryote is. So it's an organism with DNA enclosed in its nucleus, okay? The next one will be kingdom. Well, if you're doing an animal, it's going to be in the animal kingdom, right? So this one, I've got Animalia. And over here for Animalia, what are the traits of an animal? And so I just did the 8 traits that we learned, right? So eukaryotic, movement, excretion, reproduction, respond environment, respiration, circulation, and heterotrophic. These are 8 traits that all animals share, right? Next one, phylum. The animal I chose, the bear, right, is chordata. So I wrote in information on chordatas. What do all chordatas share? Okay. Next one, class. Mammalia. What are all the traits that mammals share? Okay. And so same thing down. Order for the bear was carnivora. Wrote down some information there on what carnivores share. Family. Uricidae. Okay, these are the bears found and specifically where they are found. Large bodies, stocky legs, long snout, small rounded ears. Okay, so I fill that in. Then the genus was the Ursus and the species was Arcto. And I did a subspecies because I did the SAHS bear. And I wrote in here, just for fun, found in Utah, South Salt Lake Valley, loves the colors blue and gold. And is the best mascot ever. So your flipbook will look similar to this, except for it'll have your animal, and it'll probably have a lot of, it'll have at least the top 2 the same. If you choose a jellyfish, it'll be a different phylum. If you choose a starfish, it'll be a different phylum. So be sure to check out the phylum To know what your taxonomy ranking is, just put into Google your animal and then write whatever the animal is and then taxonomy levels. And then it'll show you each level one by one. If you end up with the tribe or a subspecies, go ahead and fill them in on the inside, kind of down here like I did subspecies right in the bottom. Again, more information than less. I want to see this side filled in, as much information as you can, okay? And then I think the easiest way to do that is once you know like what the phylum is, to go ahead and go back to Google and put in the phylum, like I would have put in Chordata, and I put Chordata characteristics, and then I put in Mammalia characteristics. So as I went down, so I looked up each one specifically, and I just didn't follow whatever it said about the bear from the beginning. I looked up each one of these because each one below is going to get more specific. Okay. If you've got any questions, send me an email, and that should be it. Hope you guys are doing great. Love you. Miss you. Bye.